You are most welcome. I'm delighted to speak to you the word of God, the word of life, and the word of encouragement. As you watch us, I want you to know that God is on your side. God is concerned about you. God is concerned about your now. God is concerned about your future. I'm speaking to you from one of our locations, that is the Reference Church Kondele, behind Tumaini Supermarket, a church you cannot miss to enjoy the presence of the Lord. I welcome you all, because I know soon and very soon, the challenge that we are facing as a nation and the challenge that the whole world is facing is coming to an end, because we are praying and we are standing on the gap. The other location is found at Lolwe, across the railway, opposite Momboleo Showground. You are most welcome as you purpose to join us. Soon and very soon, the doors are open and we must gather together to worship the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Once again today, I want to talk about the power behind prayer. I remember we talked about about God and prayer, and today I want us to continue to talk about the power behind prayer. Very important and very powerful. What the world needs today and what the world needs tomorrow and forever is the foundation and power of prayer. Now, I want you to turn with me to the book of John, chapter number 15, quickly, verse number 7 and verse number 8, even as we lay the foundation of prayer. It's important for us to understand the meaning of prayer, because many times we talk about prayer, we challenge people to pray, we challenge nations to go down on their knees and pray and seek the Lord. But you can realize that a bigger population does not understand the power behind prayer. Friends, brothers and sisters, whoever you are and wherever you are watching me from, I want to encourage you to follow me, even as I release this word of God to you or to us. Now, John chapter number 15, verse number 7 and verse number 8, I read, the word of God declares, if you abide in me, Jesus is talking to us. He's not just talking to one individual, but he's talking to all of us as the children of the Most High God. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire. You will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. Now, there are issues here that every child of God must understand. Number one, Jesus is talking about himself. And Jesus is addressing us to be connected to him and his word, so that by the combination of us in him and his word, we will be able to have the foundation of asking anything in prayer, and we will receive. So friends, brothers and sisters, in verse number 8 of John chapter 15, the Bible says, by this, that means if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you are now able to have the foundation of confidence to ask anything and you receive it. Verse number 8 says, by this my Father is glorified. By this my Father is glorified. That means when we pray and we ask God of anything in Christ Jesus and by the authority of his word, then the Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples. Now, Jesus is looking for fruits. Jesus is looking for production. Jesus is looking for increase and growth. That is why it is very vital, it is very important, when we take much time to pray than taking much time to talk about issues. What we are doing now and what is happening in our generation right now is that we have a bigger population who are talking too much than even taking time to pray. Philippians chapter 4, verse number 6. The Bible says, be careful for nothing, But in everything by prayer, in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. We have many requests, and we want God to answer and respond to our requests. Friends, brothers and sisters, I know and I'm aware that we all have requests. We all have desires. We all have challenges. We all have troubles that we need the Lord to solve in our lives. And how is God going to solve these challenges and problems? He's only going to solve them by prayer. He's only going to solve them when we go down on our knees, we humble ourselves, and we realize that without God, there is nothing we can achieve and there is nothing we can have. Friends, now the question is, man of God, you've talked about prayer, and many men of God have talked about prayer, but I don't really understand what prayer is. Now, I said, and I will repeat again, that prayer is not just mentioning things or words. No, there is something deeper than that. So what is prayer? In simple explanation, whereby everybody will be able to understand and begin to pray, prayer is joining forces with God to accomplish His will in the earth. I will repeat again, what is prayer, man of God? Why must I pray? Do I really understand what prayer is? Do I really know the meaning of prayer? Friends, brothers and sisters, the meaning of prayer must be made simple and clear. Prayer is joining forces with God. Why must we join forces? So that we can accomplish His will here on earth. I want to join forces with my God. And by doing so, I will be able to fulfill. I'll be able to accomplish. I'll be able to do His will here on earth. Friends, prayer is fellowship with your Heavenly Father. When you fellowship with your God in prayer, you are asking, you are thanking, you are appreciating. Friends, for me to live, for you to sleep and wake up the following morning, it takes the hand of God. So we must reach a place where we need to appreciate and give God thanks for protecting us and taking care of us. Friends, prayer is talking to God. Prayer is simply talking to God. God, I want to talk to you. God, I want to release my heart. God, I want to release those pains that are in my heart. Now, sometimes we release our pains, we release our challenges, we release our issues to people, but I want you to realize and I want you to know that when you talk to God as your Heavenly Father, when you talk to God as your Creator, when you talk to God as a God who knows your beginning and your end, then you realize that this God, our God, who knows everything, will be able to answer to your request. Friends, based on relationship with God, according to the word of God, then you are able to pray a prayer which is effective and powerful. Let me talk shortly about having a relationship with God. Many people go before God, or they want to touch God, they want God to do great things to them. But many times we don't have a relationship, and this causes us to give up even before we go far or farther in prayer, because we lack that relationship, intimate relationship. And I said earlier on that for you to have an intimate relationship with God, you must observe a few things from the Bible. Number one, for me to have a relationship with God, it must begin by me repenting my sins and accepting Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, So that by having and by accepting Christ as my personal Savior, then a relationship begins. That foundation begins. I begin to access my Heavenly Father. Brothers and sisters, please note that you cannot pray outside the Word of God and His will and you expect results. I repeat again, brothers and sisters, as you watch me, that you cannot pray outside the Word of God and His will and you expect results or you expect answers. We pray in accordance to His Word. We pray in accordance to His will. We pray with a clean and a righteous heart. Friends, we must pray. By all means, we must pray. Now, I ask a question. Why must we pray? Why must we pray? Child of God, brothers and sisters, men and women of God, right now, as you can see, we are going through panic. We are going through fear. We are going through economical challenges in this world. How can we come out of these things? Friends, I said earlier that in every nation right now, people are locked in their houses because of this coronavirus. Everybody is asking, when will this one end? I want to say this categorically from my heart, that this will end when the church, when you and me will purpose to pray a perfect, powerful prayer from our hearts. We have answers. We have solutions. We can depend purely on God for these answers. Brothers and sisters, John Wesley says that God is limited by our prayer life. It seems He can do nothing for humanity unless man asks. I'll repeat again, John Wesley says, and I quote him, that God is limited by our prayer life. It seems He cannot do nothing for humanity unless man asks. That means God is waiting for you to ask. That means God is waiting for the church to ask so that He can act. That means no asking, no action. So if the church is going to ask, if believers are going to ask, if the counties are going to ask, if the nation is going to ask, then God has no choice. He has to act. And I want to pray right now that in the name that is above every name, our Heavenly Father, we bow before you. And we are praying that in the name that is above every name, have mercy upon us, O God. Save our children. Save our nation. Save our generation. Father, we ask this in the name that is above every name, and that is the name of Jesus. We have an opportunity to ask God to release things from His kingdom. So, those who are watching me, friends, brothers and sisters, I want to ask you now to prepare so that as we pray, you will receive the impossible from God, not from man. You will receive the desires of your heart. You will receive that which you've yearned for years, in Jesus' mighty name. My dear Father, as we pray today, we have faith in your word and we believe, King of Glory, that all things are possible to them who believe in you. As I pray for these dear sons and daughters, men and women who are watching me, I want to pray for your healing. I want to pray for your comfort. I want to pray for your encouragement, oh God. I want to pray for your healing. There are many who are bound in sicknesses and diseases. Father, I declare your healing right now. I declare, Father, that you're going to give them joy. You're going to restore them. Restore this family right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to declare the blood of Jesus upon us. Thank you, dear Father, because we know and we believe that great things are ahead of us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, I prayed and believed. Amen.